G'day all, Mr. Paladin here, and lately I've been getting a lot of questions about my HUD and all the customizations on it. I've done a video before about my HUD, showing, you know, where I get it from and such, but I'll go into a bit more specifics because there's been a lot of... There's been a lot of questions about my HUD. In particular, a lot of people have been asking about the closed captioning that I have on the lower right hand side. So things like Uber activated, even though I can hear the game sounds, I turn on the closed captioning so you guys can hear what's going on, even though I'm talking over it or maybe I've got music over it. But things like Spy around here in particular showing up in yellow can sometimes get your attention. So let's take a look at where you can download the HUD and how you can customize the options. First go to tunehud.com and there's a big download button, it'll download the zip. Underneath that is a button for the installation guide, so if there's anything you're unclear about, click on the installation guide and it can step you through every part of the download and install process. I'll go over a few things here, but pay special attention to this customize option. A lot of people miss the customization. If you're freshly installed or you already have an install, it'll look something like this, showing a change log or what happened in this version that you're about to install. Be sure and check back if there's a game update, because some people had problems with like their contracts in the current update, but if you come and update your HUD, it should fix those contract problems. Go ahead and look through the overrides. There's some I like. I'm a big fan of things like showing my disguise animation and seeing a transparent view model. Transparent view model, I think, is a plus for a lot of people, being able to see a lot of the screen and being able to see your enemies. Some of these things I like to have centered, so I can see them. I've got a big power meter so I can see things like my cloak meter. But I don't change much with the demo man charge meter or the sticky bomb counter. I do use the side profile class model because I want to know how far my weapon's sticking out when I'm disguised. It helps remind me. Don't do anything besides default on the color tab or the color 2 tab. I think they're both default. Health crosses, if anything, I've changed it to medium. I don't know if I changed anything here. I don't know if medium's the default. But on the fonts, I'm definitely using the TF2 font, and the font is called the TF2 build. I'll show later how to get a hold of the TF2 build font. On the remove tab, I don't think I get rid of anything. On the crosshair tab, I know I turn on the image hit marker, so a red or a blue pip will show if I hit an enemy. That's definite plus. I do like the team colored image on the bottom left corner. Being a spy and changing my disguise, I sometimes forget which team I'm on. On the damage indicator, be sure and change it to the TF2 build font, which I'll explain how to get a hold of. On the kill feed tab, I do not change much, but I do change the max death notices. I like to see if a whole bunch of my team has died or a whole bunch of the enemy has died, so I know if I need to be defensive or offensive at any given time. Bookmarks, no, I don't do anything with that. And closed caption, yes, I turned this on. This was the feature I've talked about. To enable the closed captions, though, you have to go into your options, audio, captioning, and turn on closed captions for this to work. I change it to the TF2 build font, just so you guys can see it while I'm recording and doing my replays and stuff. On the settings tab, just make sure it matches your TF2 install location and your screen resolution. And click update if you're ever behind on your update. If there was a major Team Fortress 2 update, do come in here and check to see if you need to update. It's quick, it's easy, and then it's done. And you can choose to start Team Fortress 2 straight from here or go to your Steam to play. Real easy. Real convenient. I like it. Now, for the TF2 build font, you can just Google TF2 build and you'll find a font website much like this one. Just be careful that you use the correct download button. It's hidden over here. Oftentimes with websites such as this, there's a lot of advertising with download buttons that will actually take you somewhere else or download something else like a file PDF viewer or something like that. That's ridiculous. Some of them can be quite malicious, so do be careful about where you click. In your options on the multiplay tab, I also have these options set. I use none for my crosshair. I draw my crosshair nice and big. I also tend to have a green hue in my crosshair. This is so I can see it against a red or a blue player, and it's quite easy to see against a blue sky or even the green grass on the ground. Thanks for watching. I hope this helps you in your future endeavors.
Non più dry farfalloni amoroso, notte giorno di torno girano, delle belle trovando al riposo, ma ci sento a tuo cino d'amor.